The Texans get set to match up with Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. Looking and finding Allen Hurns. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory, down at the 33. First down, Prescott. And the catch made here by Marquise Lee. 12 more yards there and another first down. Well, they're piecing together a nice drive to start this one. Seems pretty scripted and pretty successful so far.
And I think they did it without our help. Because you remember when we sat in the production meeting with them to talk about this and, hey, you know, how are you guys going to come out of the gate? I know I offered my help with a few plays, and they didn't seem to want it.
I didn't offer mine.
Well, you were the smart one. Whatever they're doing, though, it's working really well.
11 more on that one and another first down. The first opportunity in the red zone for the Cowboys. They've got a first and goal from the 10-yard line. They go play action here on first down. On the move to his left. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down.
I think the last two plays really illustrate how difficult it is to game plan against this guy because you know he can throw the football, but how about his use of legs as well? What we call those broken plays, you can't account for them.
Yeah, those plays, those two that you just mentioned, a microcosm really of how he can hurt you. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Hayden Hurst there to make the grab. And the Cowboys take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Dan Bailey now for the extra point. Bailey got the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Now a play fake here on first down. Sliding out of the pocket. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Hey! Play action from Miller. Now Watson out to his left. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. He was trying to hit Thomas that time, and it'll bring up third down.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tucker roll that they can fall back on anymore.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. Throwing on third down, Watson being chased out left. He can run for it, and he will. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 10 yards there, good enough for a Texan first down.
Someone knew exactly where he needed to get to pick up that first down. Now, I'm not so sure about the technique in getting there, but he went for it, and he got it.
Exactly. He knew where he needed to get, because remember, if he slides, when that derriere dips, if you will, that play's over.
The derriere dips, I like that one.
Yeah, been working on it for a little bit. Off of play action, it's Watson. They'll roll it out, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. DeMarcus Lawrence in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the scrambler or the dodger. Instead, they keep losing yardage and losing yardage and digging themselves a hole that they can't get out of.
To throw on second is Watson. He gets this one to Bruce Ellington. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now, or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
They do get nine, but it leads to fourth down. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. It's Watson. He may try and run for this. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. Around the NFL, an update from a game going on down in Tampa. And the Bucs are out to an early lead. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. They'll step off the 5 yards.
Yeah, partner, you know, defensive end, he wants to get into the offensive backfield. He wants that get off to be as fast as possible. A little too quick on that one.
Faking the give. Now Watson. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Deontay Foreman, the intended target, out of the backfield. That'll bring up second down.
Well, touch and timing are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Now a first carry for Lamar Miller. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. It was Eric Reed in on the stop.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who could do more than one thing. And I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. First time they've hooked up here. Good for 17 and a first down.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in the paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone? Here's Watson now on second down. And he'll lay out and pull it in. What a diving catch there. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
As you watch that one unfold, didn't you think to yourself, just knock it down because of where he was?
Great catch, but losing yardage.
Hard to change what they are, isn't it? When they see the ball in the air, they're programmed to go get it.
The Texans on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. Here it's third and 3. Here's Watson, flushed out right. He can run for it, and he will. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. So no sack. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, but it'll still bring up a fourth down.
But there was pressure all around him, so the only play was to try and get out of there. I think it was an excellent effort by him just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
And the first play will be a field goal try. Right hash, 37-yard attempt. The kick by Fairbairn is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they get the field goal, but that was a 14-play drive to get 3.
It sounds like you're going negative on me.
I was.
Sounds like you think the 3 is just not that good.
And people say that we're negative sometimes. So.
Well, here's the deal. Getting the 3 is good. Obviously, you would think on a 14-play drive you're going to get 6 out of it. But that type of a drive can pay dividends later on because you might wear the defense down.
And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for 4 quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade 6s for 3s, things are going to work out in your favor.
Rolling to his left. And incomplete on the deep ball. He was looking for Terrence Williams that time, and that'll bring up second down. By the way, as we expected, most of the starting units out here in the second quarter, so get your 2 deep, your 3 deep, your 4 deep ready for this one.
If you have a particular favorite who wasn't a high draft pick or is an undrafted free agent trying to make the team, this is the time to watch him play and give it his best shot, because most of the starters, you're exactly right, they'll be out of the game watching the rest of the way.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Throwing here, rush. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. Hey, a sidebar worth noting is that preseason cuts have changed. So week 3 that we're in right now, the preseason, I think what you said, the roster's going to stay at 90 instead of going down to 75 this year?
That's exactly right, Brandon, because in the past, just what you said, this game here at the end of week 3 or game 3, you would cut your roster down to 75 and play game 4 just like that. In this case now, though, they're going to be able to keep guys all the way through. So guys who would normally not have a chance to finish out the preseason, they'll get that chance now and get more opportunities to get on tape.
Good starting field position for the Houston Texans here as they come up first and 10.
Come on, let's go!
And now the first throw for the backup quarterback. Rolling to his right. That's caught right side by Anderson. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
He was out there waving his arms. And when you've got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you've got to get his attention. Because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
A carry for Foreman. And he's got this one across midfield into Cowboy territory. A three-yard pickup on second and four. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard. Again, it's Foreman. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
We all love to have a home run hitter in the backfield. Guy can take him the distance. But a short yardage, trying to pick up first downs. That big guy, always a nice luxury to have, isn't he?
10 yards there, good enough for a Texan first down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. It's Webb. Griffin's got it. Middle of the field. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. His first catch of the game. Good for 11 and a first down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations.
And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. Sammy Coates, 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Texans are in for six. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him, let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC.
Run after catch. And he loves that. And he's going to carry that in at contract time.
Fairbairn good with the extra point. And the lead is now 10-7. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And now here come the Cowboys. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a second and three, second and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks, because then the defense has the advantage.
Throwing on first down. Rush. Buying time to his left. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So they will tread backward on the holding penalty.
And I know that they're going to get coached up and they'll get yelled at a little bit. But let's face it, it is hard not to do at the speed and pace that they play.
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Off the play fake. Rush steps away. Now he's going to throw deep back over the middle. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Brandon Coleman was the intended target. And it's second down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Looking to throw on second down. Rush. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Throwing on third and long. Rush. Flush to his right. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the field. It got his man complete. A big play here for Dallas. And even 40 yards.
Well, they just treated third and long as simply an opportunity to make an even bigger play. Normally, you're just trying to pick up the first down, and you know where the sticks are. They took this thing way downfield. Confidence in the receivers to go up and make the play, even with defenders around them.
This is Scarborough. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
He'll rifle this one deep right. He rifles one that's intercepted. Tristan Decoud picks it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Flip it out! Come on, let's go! White, 90, cut!
On first down, it's Webb, escaping the pressure right. And this one is incomplete.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit and they may have to change accordingly.
Let's go! One, nine!
Back to the air on second down. Webb throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Sammy Coates, the intended target there. And it's third down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground.
Here we go! White 90! Cut!
To throw on third down, Webb. He finds Coates complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. 16 yards on that one, and also a Texan first down. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Houston after this timeout. Here's Foreman. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe
under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. The Texans on third down. They've converted four times out of six. Not bad. This is third down and 12. A play fake. Now Webb. He hits blue. And he's able to get out to the 32. Brought down there. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On fourth down, here's the veteran Shane Leckler to punt it away. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Steps away to his left. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down. The Cowboys looking to get going again in a hurry.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
He'll buy some time right. Try to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Dylan Cole.
Get what what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
First and 10, Webb is just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and it'll bring up a second down. Webb now from the gun. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Well, good field position to start the drive, but under the gun now here on 3rd and 8. Out of the gun, it's Webb. Eluding the pressure right. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down.
So when the defense complains about having to do pursuit drills in the heat of training camp, plug in this play. Excellent pursuit. Force the quarterback out of the pocket. He ends up trying to run for it. Instead, he goes out of bounds and loses yardage. That goes down as a sack for the defense.
Still a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they do get 3 before the half and expand that lead.
And they have to be happy about that. And we haven't met a team yet that doesn't put an emphasis on trying to get points on the board in the last 2 minutes of a half. They'll be real excited to have those up on the board.
The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Lucky 56. Let's go.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw, and that'll be incomplete.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. Now Scarborough. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. 8 yards on the ground there, and now they're looking at a 3rd and 2.
All right, now, Lucky 56. Lucky 56. Gone.
A final shot before break. Rush. He's going to wind up and air it out. It's caught inside the 25. You want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it. So we are halfway through here in the final week of the preseason. The Texans offense now, they get set to head back on the field here. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done, they're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else. They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive gain. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's 3rd down. The Texans on 3rd down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This will be 3rd and 5.
Flex round. Let's go.
Operating from the gun, Webb. And he's unable to haul it in. So it falls incomplete over the middle third of the field. And that brings up 4th. Here's Shane Leckler now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out if that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. Rush. And he's going to be grabbed and pulled down. The four-time All-Pro. J.J. Watt, and that's going to lead to a third and 12. Prescott. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And he can't quite intercept it. Zone coverage, free safety was there. Couldn't come up with it, and now it's fourth down. Out now comes the Cowboys punter, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And taken right on the 30. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Texans will take over with a first and 10. Now the Texans offense, they head back out to do battle here. They were forced to punt last time, and I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do they. Great starting spot, great opportunity to run your full playbook. If they want to take a shot here, they can go ahead and do it.
Now a first down throw. Well, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Malik Collins, never giving up. He's able to keep working and get him for a loss of 12. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Play action. Webb sliding out of the pocket. Looking sideline, incomplete. They were trying to get the connection with a former Buckeye, Braxton Miller. And now it's third down. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down. Then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back. But it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
They'll roll him out right. And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, we quit counting yardage on that one, didn't we? That was truly third and a mile, wasn't it?
It was. I thought they might just go underneath, but they didn't. They wanted to get the first down there.
Yeah, they tried to pick up the huge chunk unsuccessfully. I'm with you. I would have tried to take some yardage just to gain some field position.
And out now come the Cowboys. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
Oh, did he hang on to it? He did on the dive. Nice grab. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar.
Circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. And it's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
A first down carry by Elliott. And he'll rumble for about five, up close to the 40.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott, forced out to his left. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down. The give is to Elliott. Able to get away. Ezekiel Elliott going to take it the distance. Touchdown, Cowboys! Ezekiel Elliott, 55 yards. And the Cowboys are now just an extra point away from moving out in front. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And now out comes Houston. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
On first down, Webb. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Sean Lee, the linebacker, able to get a hand in coverage.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
Yeah, and he will go down. A Cowboys sack.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
The Texans on third down. They're right at about the league average, 40%, 4 for 10. This will be a tough third and 18. Off the play fake, Webb. And that is incomplete.
I would dare say that these guys will have liked to have given their defense a little bit more rest since they gave up a touchdown their last time out. But alas, my man, that's not going to happen.
Yep, they're going to have to grab those helmets, get right back out there. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. That's taken on the 25. That'll wind up being a 50-yard punt, though they do get 10 back on the return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. So good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10. They start on the ground with Elliott. And an Elliott run! And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let them get to the second level, because sometimes...
That's caught inside the 20! And he'll be down deep in Houston territory. A gain of 39 that time.
So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Here's Prescott on the move to his left. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
They come out here in the eye. On second down, Elliott. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. The Cowboys on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Alan Hearns taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Cowboys will extend their lead. And this is blocked. The defense picks it up, but he doesn't get far. They're able to stop him. And after all that, the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
Well, times have definitely changed on the PAT, on the extra point, haven't they? A lot more effort goes into this play from both sides.
Yeah, because let's face it, a lot of time on extra points, the effort is not what it is when you're trying to block a field goal.
No, no doubt about it. And before, when the ball was snapped on the 2-yard line, it was really a virtual chip shot. Now everyone believes they can get to it and not get away. And we know how crucial every point is. So the defensive guys just got a lot more time.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up 1st and 10.
Ohio! Flex round! Flex round!
Back! Now a run. This is Alfred Blue. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
Ohio!
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down. To throw, Webb. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Griffin. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
But when you hit him on the move like that, and he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam, oh, boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. And this one caught by Coates. The completion good for 3, and it's 2nd down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Throwing again on 2nd down, but this time it's incomplete. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up 3rd down. They got to get it to the 21 here on 3rd down. From the gun, Webb, and he comes back with 1 complete, and he's in, touchdown, Houston, Alfred Blue, 27 yards, and the Texans are an extra point away from tying this football game. Don't forget the extra point, it's up and good, and we are tied here in the 4th quarter. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild 4th quarter. The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll start the drive with Elliott. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. J.J. Watt, the one that gets him down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding him to no gain.
He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And now out comes Houston. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
Going for the deep ball. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
There's definitely contact there, but it's the fourth quarter of a kind of tight game, and sometimes the officials just say, let them play. Kind of like your mom used to with you and your brothers, just take the broom to you and send you out to your backyard and tell you to settle yourselves.
I like that, yeah. There was contact, I don't know, like you said, enough to warrant the flag. It was close, though. Off play action, Webb. Throw left side, complete. It's Griffin. They'll get nine there as that sets him up better for third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
He lost two, and it brings up four.
How about the fellas with the stars on the side of their helmets rising up on defense? We always hear about the Cowboys' rushing offense. Their rush defense is pretty good as well, I think because they're so cohesive. Defensive line, linebackers really work well together.
Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. Boy, an incredibly aggressive move to go for it there. Game tied fourth quarter. You got to be surprised.
I am, and I know that we're in a new era of football where we look at the analytics sometimes, and a lot of time the analytics tell you to go for it, right? But do the analytics take into account game situation, where we are, all those things? In this situation, I thought it was an incredibly aggressive play.
It didn't work out. And again, tie game fourth quarter makes this thing a little bit more interesting. Again to Elliott. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a first and 10. After the penalty, it's Allen. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, it'll be second down. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. In trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Second down throw for Prescott. A dump off to Elliott. And he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
Well, it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center eligible stuff, but still a lot of guys to account for.
Prescott now. Perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. first and 10, Prescott. And this is going to be intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. And they get the football, but not much on the return here as he stopped at the 7-yard line. Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this. They start the drive with a give to Blue. And he's going to be taken down here at about the 10. A gain of 3, second down. It's hurry-up mode time for the Texans, hustling up to the line. Webb now. And incomplete. Alfred Blue, the man he was looking for. And that'll make it third down.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle. Got to totally command and make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
Here we go. Grand 38. Grand 38.
On third down, Webb. And this is going to be incomplete. Fourth down now, and defensively, Charles, you know, they're just asking this crew for one more stop.
And you know that they're feeling the momentum right now. But they have to be very careful not to get over-exuberant, over-excited, and blow an assignment and give up the big first down.
And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got three on the board for sure. And come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? That goes for a gain of 31.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. And now the Texans are going to stop it as they signal for a timeout. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. And now the Texans want to call another timeout. As the clock stops here with 46 seconds left to play. Now Elliott. And that's a touchdown as they've broken our tie here in the final minute of the fourth.
I don't know how many more of these my heart can take, my man. I just don't know. Another big touchdown late in the game. They look like they're in control, but still, there's a chance. Block the extra point, go down and score, kick the extra point themselves. They can pull this one out.
Yeah, but also on the sideline that just took the lead, you got to get your defense ready and the special teams unit for the kickoff coming up.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Got to pull everyone together and make sure they're still focused and aren't already celebrating a win.
And now out comes Houston. One possession game. Time very much a factor. How does the offense... handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't...
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Lewis. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? because you can make an educated guess defensively. Not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Taking a knee is not in vogue. They're not able to add another touchdown on, and now the ball game is over. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never.
My have an all white rank. Couldn't hit if had ain't. Lanes can't call and you lame. You had it and you lost it, all the shine. I can buy a Billy, don't talk to me. For a show 150, don't talk to me. You ain't never helped your mans, don't talk to me. You just follow all the trends, don't talk to me. I set the bar, I'm the bar. Look in the sky, I'm a star. I don't fall in love, cause I be loving, cause I be loving. They ain't like my shirt, it's a large. I don't care, I crush a ghost. Got two cribs in two states, I be doing the most. I got white folks' money that I won't blow. And if you ask why, cause the white folks don't. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Type of money you gon' need a sight. The type of money you gon' need a bank. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you, gon' let you. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank.
Everything proper, no propaganda. Chopper count a gold yard bandana. Big, big, a lot of like Santa. Threw a birthday party in a phantom. Big, big, like a dinosaur did it. And you know, shining like acrylic. Yeah, yeah, I had cornrows. I can see you hanging with the door closed. Now I'm looking for a glove with a sparkle on it. And my got chocolate on it. Big bank, take small. Bank account on some tall. Attitude on some. Bank roll on what it do, boo. At the rule at five, and if I ain't did it yet, I'll try.
Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Type of money you gon' need a sight. The type of money you gon' need a buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you, let you. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank.
She said, what you gon' do if I leave? I said, I'ma do me. B-I-G, everything zoomed in. Big, big on me looking like I'm moving in. Got my foot in the door and we still here. I'm a first generation millionaire. I broke the curse of my family not having. I'm passionate like us after more than just cashing. Feed me to the wolves, now I lead the packet. You boys all cap, I'm more Colin Kaepernick. I'm rare as affordable healthcare. Or going to wealth from welfare. I turn my W's to yeah, I those. Ooh. I might buy a red bottoms with the crypto. Three coins, that'll pay your whole semester. Sure, sure. But you gotta bet it in a Tesla.
Big bank, tight, low, buy, buy. Big bank, tight, low, buy, buy. Type of money you gon' need a sight. The type of money you gon' need to buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you, let you. Big bank, tight, low, buy, buy. Big bank, tight, low, buy, buy.
Back again, back to back, made back, stacked it. I'm a Slim Shady, baby, the M. Once he black, he'll be back again. Tell him that it's crunch time abdomen. Yes, I caught Mad Chanel and Mad Javin. She did it again, imagine them. About to make these bums mad again. Uh-oh. Back to them. I lead the packs on my backs to them. Yup, the queen's back. What's happening? Rerun, about to make these rap again. Diamond chains on my ankle. Young money in the cut like a tell tip rubber bands on my bankroll. Show my like a
big bank, tight, low buy, buy. Big bank, tight, low buy, buy. Type of money you gon' need a sight. Type of money you gon' need a buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you, let you. Big bank, tight, low buy, buy. Big bank, tight, low buy, buy.
out, G go too fast. Only one no seatbelt. Bad lil' got no. Oh great, now she got. How about the range on? Who is lil' baby? He going in. Man, these old rappers getting boring. They be taking shots, I ignore them. Send them to the hood while I'm touring. Making plays out of town like I'm Jordan. Need to go get your. Walk on my way, I'ma score it. Lamborghini, I don't want no Porsches. I'ma fire, don't touch me, I'm torching. Had a fist on my teeth, I went Porsche. Put the time on my back, I'm a horseman. One more year, I'ma make it a fourless. They load me in the bay like he 40. I be sitting inside of the Moreland. Ain't no strings attached, keeping it cordless. She keep calling, but I keep ignoring it. Ain't no stopping, I'm keeping it for it. Many can't stop me, I'm going it. Many can't stop me, I'm going it. Every time I'm gone, I get another. Tryna leave me long. Baby, I know I'm wrong, but this just how life goes. And I know they'd be happy if I let you go. Got me walking on a thin line on my tippy toes. Crazy different city with some different. Here we go. Every time I'm gone, I get another. Tryna leave me long. Another. I'm like, baby, I know I'm wrong, but this just how life goes. And I know they'd be happy if I let you go. Got me walking on a thin line on my tippy toes. Crazy different city with some different. Here we go.
I spend the whole M on some clothes. Got a bonus, I sold out the show. Gonna like a pot on the stove. Yellow AP on all of my. I like when that white on her toes. Picture me riding around in that rose. I put some ice on my wrist, it was woes. Then I ain't got time with you. All of these my body, I got been somebody keep checking my pose. Walk in the club with no money, take care of the money. They swing on the. Water on me like the sunny, I shine when it's sunny, this platinum and rose. Gonna out the street when I go to DC, I'ma see the mo.
Every time I'm gone.